Channel Diary of TB. My name is Tia. If you like the video, you could like the video. If you don't like the video, you could dislike the video. Please share, comment, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Selamat datang di channel YouTube saya, Diary of TB. Nama saya Tia. Apabila kamu menyukai video ini, silakan di like. Apabila tidak menyukainya, silakan di dislike. Jangan lupa di share, comment, dan subscribe. Bagi kamu yang baru di channel saya, selamat datang. Selamat menikmati channel saya. Bagi kalian yang sudah sering nonton tapi belum subscribe, tolong di subscribe. Dan bagi kalian yang sudah subscribe, terima kasih atas supportnya. Saya sangat membutuhkan itu, dan ya, saya sangat appreciate itu ya. For you who new in my channel, welcome to my channel, and please enjoy my channel, and don't forget to subscribe. For you who already existing viewers in my channel but you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. And for you who already subscribed, thank you for your support. It really meant for me. Okay guys, sekarang gue mau, tadi gue udah bikin untuk general reading untuk Virgo di bulan Agustus 2021. I just made video for Virgo monthly reading, general reading for August 2021. Right now I'm going to make love reading for Virgo for August 2021. Sekarang saatnya saya bikin bacaan untuk percintaannya Virgo di bulan Agustus 2021. Okay. Disclaimer, this is a general reading. It also a fun reading. I collected many random energy from several of different people. So this reading, it could be about you, or it could be about the person that you try to dealing with. It may resonate with you, or it may not resonate with you. Just take out what resonate with you. If it's not resonate at all, you could check your sun, moon, rising, and Venus sign, because it's energy. It could be vice versa, and also it is interchangeable. Ini disclaimer, in bacaan ini sifatnya umum. This reading is also fun reading ya. Bacaan ini sifatnya umum dan untuk senang-senang aja, ya, untuk seru-seruan aja. Bacaan ini bisa tentang kamu, energi kamu yang kebaca, atau bisa juga energi orang yang sedang dekat dengan kamu yang kebaca sama saya, karena saya menarik energi secara acak dari beberapa orang, dari beberapa orang yang berbeda. Jadi bisa nyambung dengan situasi kamu, atau bisa juga tidak nyambung dengan situasi kamu. Disesuaikan saja bacaan ini dengan situasi kamu. Pasti ada beberapa poin yang memang nyambung gitu dengan situasi kamu. Tapi kalau memang tidak nyambung sama sekali, tolong cek sun, moon, rising, dan Venus-nya kalian. Karena ini kan energi ya, sifatnya bisa terbolak dan terbalik, vice versa gitu loh guys. Okay, let's get started. Dear God, angels, universe, divine power, angels, spirit guide, what will happen? Just give me a sign about what will happen with Virgo people during this August 2021. Dear God, angels, universe, angel, spirit guide, what will happen? Angel, just give me a sign. What will happen with Virgo people during this August 2021? Dear God, angels, universe, divine power, archangel, spirit guide, bright light, God, guardian angel, please give me a sign. What will happen with Virgo regarding their love life during this August 2021? random. I just got one. Dear God, angels, universe, divine power, our angel spirit, bright light, God, guardian angel, please give me a, okay. Please give me a sign about Virgo people during this August 2021. Oops. Regarding about their love life. Dear God, angels, universe, divine power. Oh, my skull. Thank you, Archangel Spirit. Wow. Jadi emang saya ngoceknya agak lama ya, karena saya hanya mengambil kartu yang lompat. It takes time for me to shuffle the card because I don't pick the card. I just only take the card to get rid it when the card is pop up or jumping card, yeah. Here card, angels, universe. Oh, okay. Too many. Virgo kayaknya gak mau dibacain deh nih. Here card, angels, universe, divine power. Archangel, spirit guide, white light, God, guardian angel, just give me a sign. What will happen with Virgo people during this? Okay. August 2021, regarding about their love life. Okay, another card, one card. I need. Okay. Dear God, angels, universe, divine power, angels, spirit, guide. Okay. Right. Bottom of the deck. You got Knight of Wands. Okay. Well. Virgo, well. Bentar ya. Kenapa ada minyak kayu putih sih di sini? Eh deh, wait, ya udah, terusin aja deh. Wait, okay. Because my desk is really, really narrow and really, really full. Okay. Yeah. Okay, Virgo, maybe this. Wait. So you could see the card. Hold on. Okay, Virgo, this is your love reading for August 2021. Wait up. Just take up my this one first. To cover my belly. My big belly. Okay. First of all, you got Queen of Wands. Where's Scott? You got Queen of Wands. There are two scenarios about this card. First scenario, if it's about you, you finally know what you have to do, Virgo, regarding about your love life. You take any risks. You don't afraid of anything. And you will just do it. Just do whatever you want. Yeah, if it's regarding about you. But second scenario is if it's about other people. There are a person here. They try to put a little black magic on you. I don't know who this person is because it's general reading. I cannot see the detail. Why I'm saying this person put a spell on you? Because look at this card. This is in this card, this Queen of Wands, she have a black cat. Black cat in myths, ancient myth, black cat is a favorite pet of a witches, right? So totally black cat is related with witch, which is like equally with magic, black magic spell. Okay, why this person put a spell on you? Maybe they feel envy about you, or maybe they don't want to lose you, they want to keep you on them because you try to move on from them, but they don't want to lose you. That's why they using some kind like a black magic spell, just put you with them forever. It's quite creepy actually. Okay, di sini ada kartu Queen of Wands. Di sini ada dua skenario. Apabila skenario pertama, apabila dia berhubungan sama kamu, kamu pada akhirnya bersikap seperti seorang Queen of Wands. Kamu tahu apa yang kamu inginkan dan kamu ya udah kamu lakuin gitu loh, nggak peduli dengan resiko yang ada, kamu tetap menjalani gitu. Nah ini kalau emang tentang kamu, tapi kalau ini tentang orang lain, skenario kedua adalah orang ini sepertinya agak-agak menggunakan ilmu hitam ya ke kamu. Kenapa dia menggunakan ilmu hitam? Ya mungkin dia ada ngerasa iri sama kamu, atau kamu pernah sakitin hatinya dia, ya mungkin dengan sikap ataupun dengan kata-kata kamu, atau bisa juga dia tahu nih kamu mau move on dari dia, dia nggak izinin kamu move on, nah dia nggak pengen kamu move on, akhirnya dia pakai ilmu hitam, sihir, pakai sihir untuk istilahnya ngelok kamu, ngunci kamu secara goib biar kamu nggak kemana-mana. Itu yang utama. Karena karakter seorang Queen of Wands itu karakter orang yang dia akan melakukan berbagai macam cara untuk mendapatkan apa yang dia mau. Karena dia tipikal orang yang menghalalkan berbagai cara, ya black magic pun juga dipakai buat sama dia gitu loh. Karena kenapa gue bilang ini black magic? Lihat ya di sini. Di sini kartu Queen of Wands ini dia punya kucing hitam nih sebagai piaraan dia. Sementara dalam mitos kuno, kucing hitam itu adalah piaraan favorit atau piaraan kesukaan para penyihir. Mungkin sekarang penyihir nggak ada, tapi penyihir 11-12 dengan dukun ya maksudnya. Jadi jelas banget si Queen of Wands ini ada seorang praktisi black magic. Entah dia yang menjadi dukunnya atau penyihirnya, atau dia memang bayar dukun gitu, bayar dia ngedukun, dia bayar orang untuk ngedukunin kamu. Wow, dan benar kalau berhubungan sama black magic, benar kan kamu dibuat nggak bisa mengambil keputusan. Karena sini ada kartu Two of Swords ya. Sebenarnya sih seharusnya bisa-bisa aja kamu ngambil keputusan, tapi entah kenapa kamu kayak dibuat dalam tanda kutip ya, dibuat secara memakai sihir, sehingga kamu tuh kayak kebingungan sendiri dan kamu tuh kayak nggak bisa ngambil keputusan, nggak bisa keluar gitu, nggak bisa berpikir secara jernih. Ini yang gue lihat. Kenapa gue bilang nggak bisa berpikir secara jernih? Coba lihat deh kartu ini. Ini ada cewek. Kedua tangan cewek ini megang pedang. Tapi matanya nih cewek tertutup. Sebenarnya penutup mata dia ini bisa dibuka kalau cewek ini mau ngebuka penutup matanya. Tapi si cewek ini ya dia bisa ngebuka dong dengan cara ya pedangnya dia taruh gitu ya. Terus tangannya dipakai buat buka penutup matanya, tapi kenyataannya perempuan ini membiarkan matanya tertutup dan tangannya tidak difungsikan untuk membuka penutup matanya, malah tangannya itu ribet megangin pedang. Nah, di sini nih, efek black magicnya ini, seharusnya kamu bisa melihat sesuatu itu dengan jelas, kamu bisa berpikir dengan jernih, tapi karena efek dari black magic ini, kamu jadi kayak dibuat bego, jadi kayak nggak bisa ngelihat situasi gitu loh, nggak bisa ngelihat segala sesuatunya dengan jelas, dengan jernih. You got two of sword. Why I'm saying this late this person using a black magic on you? Because actually the situation you could think clearly. You could get clarity if I said if yeah, if you wanted to. But you don't let yourself to see clearly, to see everything clearly. You don't let yourself to get a clarity. Why? Because you let yourself blinded. That's why you cannot make decision. You feel stuck on that situation, on that level of situation. You could look at this card. This is a woman. This woman holding a sword, holding two swords with her two hands. One sword in one hand. So two swords in two hands. Meanwhile, her eyes had been covered by a blindfolded. Yeah. If this woman get a clarity, she could take away the sword and she could using her hands, her two hands, to open the blindfold. But what she did, she didn't take the blindfold. She let her eyes covered by a blindfold, so she cannot see things clearly. She just too busy with the two sword on her hands, on her each hands. That's why this black magic I'm saying, oops, this black magic I'm saying make you like this, Virgo. Make you like this. You cannot see things clearly. Supposed to be you could see things clearly, supposed to be, but because you are in a under control, under the spell of a black magic, you cannot see things clearly. This person making you in this position, okay? Ya, jadi kan sebenarnya ya, ya jangan ribet sama pedangnya. Kalau dia mau, perempuan ini mau nurunin pedangnya, dia pakai tangannya untuk ngebuka matanya, berarti kan perempuan ini bisa ngelihat segala sesuatunya dengan jelas. Tapi kan perempuan ini membiarkan matanya tertutup, tangannya nih perempuan malah sibuk megangin pedang, which is nggak faedah banget sih sebenarnya menurut gue, gitu kan? Kenapa dia bisa kayak gitu ya? Karena dia ada di bawah pengaruh ilmu sihir itu, jadi dia nggak bisa berpikir secara jernih, gitu loh. Jadi kamu Virgo, kamu nggak bisa berpikir secara jernih. Kenapa ya? Kamu di bawah pengaruh sihir, masalahnya. Okay, third card is Four of Pentacles. This person, it totally cannot let things go. This could be you, or this could be your person. Basically, this person cannot be moved on. Maybe, if this is you, this person who using black magic made you feel stuck and cannot see things clearly. That's why you cannot let things go. You cannot let these things go. That's why. Or. Because this person, maybe they have some kind of obsession with you. That's why they don't want to let you go. They hold you back. By what? By using black magic. Basically, this situation is quite toxic. Totally toxic. This is a love is a blind love. Is love is a blind. Yeah, this person make themselves blinded by love, and that's not healthy. That's not good. Orang ini sepertinya tidak bisa move on dari kamu. Ini ada dua skenario ya. Skenario pertama, ini mungkin kamu. Kamu tuh kayak nggak bisa move on dari situasi ini. Kenapa kamu nggak bisa move on? Kamu tuh dibuat stuck sama orang ini, gitu. Dibuat stuck. Caranya gimana? Ini orang bikin kamu stuck. Orang ini menggunakan black magic. Orang ini menggunakan sihir. Makanya kamu sengaja dibuat stuck dan nggak bisa move on. Gak bisa lepas dari masalah ini, gak bisa keluar dari masalah ini. Tapi kalau ini berhubungan, skenario keduanya, ini kalau ini berhubungan dengan orang lain atau orang yang sedang berdealing sama kamu, yang sedang dekat sama kamu, orang ini mungkin kayak punya semacam obsesi terhadap kamu, sehingga dia gak mau kehilangan kamu. Gimana cara dia nahan kamu, gimana cara dia bisa membuat kamu tidak pergi? Dia pakai black magic. Dia ngunci kamu secara goib pakai black magic. Makanya kamu gak bisa kemana-mana. Jahat sih kalau menurut gue. Jahat banget ya orang, sumpah. Wow. Okay. But the good thing is, Virgo, you have a stable emotion, stable character, stable head over heart character. You always think first before you act. You're the typical kind of person who always using your logic rather than your heart. Okay, so this is like a decision head over heart. Okay, because your stable behavior or your stable traits or your stable character makes you strong. Ya. Di sini kamu pada dasarnya Virgo itu adalah orang-orang yang memang punya semacam karakter yang kuat dan stabil. Mereka itu tipikal orang yang selalu pakai logika dulu sebelum bertindak. Selalu mikir dulu lah sebelum bertindak. Dan Virgo itu tipikal orang yang pakai logika dulu daripada ngedengerin kata hati. Bagusnya kamu adalah kamu orang yang stabil karakternya. Bagusnya kamu. Nah, kestabilan kamu itu akhirnya membuat kamu bisa terlepas dari orang ini. Kestabilan kamu itu bisa membuat kamu terlepas dan akhirnya kamu pergi meninggalkan orang ini. Orang yang telah iniin kamu, ngedukunin kamu. Because in here, you have a stable traits, you have a stable behavior. Your stability character makes you finally could get out, could move on from this toxic situation. You could heal, you could cure from the black magic this person tried to put on you. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. Sometimes, ya. Yeah. Kalau menurut orang, ini menurut orang yang pernah gue dengar dari orangnya. Orang yang stabil karakternya, istilahnya ngejejak karakternya, itu agak susah didukunin. Jadi makanya supaya kalian nggak mempan dukunin, tetaplah punya karakter yang ngejejak gitu, membumi atau nginjak tanah. Jadi biar kalian yang nggak mudah untuk dikontrol pakai ilmu sihir. Many people said in my tradition as Indonesian people, because Indonesian is really really identical with black magic, with psychic, something like that. Yeah, something like black magic kind of stuff lah. That's why people in here, I mean Indonesian people, they have some kind like they believe in superstitious, they believe in mystical things. And people here said if you have a stay grounded character, if you have a stable character, stable emotion, it's really hard for you to get controlled by the spell of the black magic. So if you don't want to be controlled by the under the black magic spell, you have to keep yourself stay grounded. You must have a stable character, stable emotion. That makes you cannot be controlled by the black magic. People said, yeah, I'm not saying that. Okay. Okay, the bottom of the deck is Nine of Wands. Finally, somebody came to you. This person is quite about rushing in. This person, quite fiery person, quite energetic. And maybe this person who tried to help you out from those black magic kind of things. Maybe. Because why this person? They rushing in into your life because they try to save you. They want to fight for you just to make you safe. I don't know who this person is. Maybe this is a new person. Maybe. Or maybe this is your ex. I don't know, but there will be a person, no matter female or male, but this person, they came rushing into your life just to save you from this black magic kind of stuff. Okay. Di sini sepertinya ada orang akan datang ke dalam hidup kamu. Ini bisa orang baru, bisa orang lama ya. Tapi orang ini jelas datangnya tuh terburu-buru gitu. Dia cepat-cepat datang ke kamu. Karena orang ini kenapa? Orang ini pengen nolongin kamu terbebas dari pengaruh ilmu sihir ini gitu. Orang ini akan memperjuangkan kamu, dia akan rela berkelahi atau dia rela untuk melakukan apapun untuk memperjuangkan kamu, Virgo. Dan ini bagus. Bagus sekali. Oke, Virgo. Oke, I'm going to read Oracle. I will confirm with the Oracle card. Gua akan konfirmasi dengan kartu Oracle ya. Virgo people during this August 2020. Dear God Angel, please bless Divine Power Angel Spirit Guide, but let God guide an angel. Please give me a sign about what will happen with Virgo people during this August 2021 regarding about their love life. Dear God, angels, universe, divine father, angel, spirit guide, what will happen, angels, give me a sign. What will happen with Virgo people during this August, during this August 2021. Okay. Dear God, angels, universe, divine power, and angel spirit God. What my God, God and angel, just give me a sign. Okay, I got one. No. Just give me a sign. What will happen with Virgo people during this August 2021 regarding about their love life. Dear God, angels, universe, divine power, archangel, spirit, God, light, God, current angel, just give me a sign. What will happen with Virgo people during this August, I keep saying July, 2021. Dear God, angels, universe. Okay. Wait, yeah, you got fine. Bottom of the deck, you got playfulness. Ooh la la, ooh la la. Wait, yeah. Same like Leo. Reading Leo. You have to deal with your ex. Gitu. Ini sama kayak readingannya Leo. Kayaknya kamu harus balik sama mantan kamu deh. Kayaknya. Bentar ya. Your first card is let your friend help you. Ask for and accept support from others. Okay. It doesn't matter, Virgo, if you're asking for help from your friends to get things throughout from this. Okay. Or maybe if one of your friends giving you some kind of favor, just if you need it, just try to accept it. Jangan gengsi kalau memang kamu butuh bantuan dari teman untuk bantu untuk menyelesaikan mencari solusi atas permasalahan kalian. Atau kalau memang ada teman kamu yang memang menawarkan bantuan, walaupun kamu nggak minta, tapi dia nawar bantuan, ya udah terima aja, jangan gengsi. Karena ya terkadang kita, ya kita nggak bisa hidup sendiri lah. Karena kita pasti membutuhkan ini orang, apa bantuan dari orang gitu. Okay. Second card is religious factor. Your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. Okay. There are some kind of scenario in here. First scenario. Maybe you and your person have a different kind of faith, have a different kind of religion. Second scenario, maybe you and your person have a different kind of things. Doesn't have to be religion, but it could be anything. Maybe your different kind of status, maybe your person or you already get married or what, or whatever it is, but you have that kind of different things between you guys. Or third scenario, what happened with you guys is already written by God and universe. No matter how chaotic your situation is, that is the scenario written by God and universe. Why God giving or written that kind of things about your life? Why God making mess into your life? Because it's for your own good, for your own spiritual growth. If you already grown spiritually, it makes you be a better person. If you already being the best version of you, you could attract abundance. That's the process. Okay. Ini ada faktor yang berhubungan sama agama. Ini ada beberapa senario. Dari pertama, mungkin kamu sama orang yang kamu lagi dekat ini mungkin beda agama. Itu satu. Yang kedua, kalau memang kalian gak beda agama, bisa juga beda hal yang lain. Misalnya perbedaan status, entah kamu atau dia sudah menikah gitu, ya. Dia sudah punya pasangan gitu ya. Atau senario ketiga, terus nomor kedua ya, beda status gitu ya. Nah, yang ketiga, apa yang terjadi sama hidup kamu, walaupun kamu istilahnya ancur-ancuran lah, sebenarnya ini sudah ditulis, skenario ini, takdir ini sudah ditulis oleh semesta dan oleh Tuhan. Dan kenapa sih kok Tuhan dan semesta kok jahat amat bikin hidup gua ancur-ancuran? Karena itu demi kebaikan kamu sendiri. Kenapa gue bilang demi kebaikan kamu? Tuhan mengacak-acak hidup kamu Karena supaya kamu bisa bertumbuh secara pribadi dan secara spiritual. Kalau kamu sudah bisa bertumbuh, kamu berhasil bertumbuh secara spiritual dan secara personal, itu artinya kamu menjadi orang yang jauh lebih baik daripada kamu yang sebelumnya. Dan kalau kamu sudah menjadi orang yang lebih baik, otomatis itu akan menarik energi, itu akan menarik rezeki, akan menarik berkah. Gitu. Makanya gue bilang, karena gini, sila kasar ya, kita dicoba, diberi cobaan berat. Kalau kita bisa menghadapinya dengan baik, bisa bersabar ya, Tuhan juga akan ngasih reward, akan ngasih hadiah yang gak tanggung-tanggung gedenya. Oke? Talking about your person, why you and your person after what happened, after shitty things happen, why you guys seems not cannot leave them out? Why you guys feel stuck with them? Maybe they are your soulmate. Because why? You have chemistry between you guys. Kenapa sih kamu sama orang ini kayak dibikin apa ya? Dibikin hancur-hancuran lah gitu sama Tuhan sama yang sama semesta. Ya mungkin orang ini itu sebenarnya sebenarnya bukan musuh kamu, jujur malah dia tuh adalah mungkin dia jodoh kamu. Kenapa? Karena yang aku lihat di sini kalian tuh punya kalian berdua punya chemistry yang sama. Gitu, tapi karena memang ada salah satu dari kalian atau mungkin kalian berdua mungkin dua-duanya nih belum bertumbuh secara spiritual, akhirnya dikasih cobaan sama Tuhan dan semesta, digoyanglah hubungan kalian. Gitu, sekaligus juga itu untuk ngetes berapa setia sih kalian berdua? Gitu loh guys, oke? Okay. Fourth card, retreat. Oh yeah, hold on. Yeah, chemistry, there strong magnetic attraction. Here ya, yeah. Chemistry. Jadi gitu, jadi ya kenapa kalian ini kok jodoh tapi kok hubungannya dibikin hancur gitu kan? Ya yeah, supaya kalian bertumbuh. Kalau kalian sudah bertumbuh kan, kalian sudah menjadi the best versinya kalian gitu loh. Istilahnya udah jadi kalian udah menjadi versi terbaiknya kalian. Sekarang gini, kita minta kepada Tuhan untuk mendapatkan yang terbaik. Nah, sekarang pertanyaan itu dibalikin lagi ke kita. Apakah kita juga sudah menjadi versi terbaiknya kita atau belum? Nah, kalau kita belum menjadi versi terbaik kita, jangan pernah minta sama Tuhan untuk mendapatkan yang terbaik gitu loh. Why I'm saying you need spiritual growth for your own good, for you being the best version of you. Like this, people use to they tend to pray and asking to God, please God, give me a better person to be my Mr. or Mrs. Right, to be my soulmate. The question is, I give it back to you. You asking God to send you a good version of your soulmate. You want a good version. You want your soulmate in a good version. But the question is, are you already became the best version of you? If you haven't been the best version of you, if you haven't became a best version of you, don't ask God to give you the best version of your soulmate. Yourself, you're the one who have to change and be the best version of you. After you change to be the best version of you, then you could ask God to send the best version of your soulmate. Okay, how can you be the best version of you? Spiritual growth. You need tower moment to trigger your spiritual growth, to trigger your spiritual awakening. And then after that, if you could learn the lesson from that, then you could be the best version of you. Okay? Itu jadi ya jangan minta yang terbaik gitu loh sebelum kita sendiri bisa menjadi yang terbaik. Dan di sini memang setelah gonjang-ganjing hubungan kalian tuh kalian memang balikan, tapi memang kalian tuh harus apa ya, kayak mulai dari nol lagi, jadi sama-sama saling mengenal lagi satu sama lain, kayak gitu loh, balik ke titik nol. Okay, and here, after all those shitty situation between you and that person, between you and your person, I mean, you could go back together, one to another, you could going back together, but you need retreat back to the zero position. Try to get to know each other again, like before. Try to isolate yourself both from the outer world. Try to focus with your internal issue, with your internal problem, with your internal matter, internal self. Try to focus with yourself and your partner also. That's the thing. You need to retreat to back to basic. Yeah, you need to retreat to get to back to basic, so you could know each other from zero. You could know each other again from zero. Okay. And when the retreat happened, you need honeymoon as a fifth card. Enjoy the bliss of holiday time together. Yeah. Honeymoon, it means you spend time together alone. It's only you and your partner. There are no other person. That's why you need time to be alone. Just two of you need to be alone in this honeymoon. Why? Because when you have alone time, both of you, you spend time together, just only you and your partner, then you could may know each other again. Maybe you could know each other better than before. Yeah. Jadi di sini ada kartu kelima, ada kartu honeymoon. Nah, disinilah retreatnya. Kenapa kalian butuh retreat? Karena dengan honeymoon itu kan kalian jadi punya waktu berdua tanpa diganggu orang lain, ya kan? Nah, dari waktu berdua ini, kalian tuh sudah bisa saling mengenal satu sama lain, bisa saling mengenal lagi satu sama lain, gitu. Bisa lebih fokus ke hubungan kalian, bisa lebih fokus ke diri kalian sendiri, gitu. And don't forget to add some playfulness in your love life, to add the spiciness and to create flame, love flame in your love life. Playfulness to recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. Ya, jangan lupa saat nanti kalian honeymoon nih, retreat, melakukan retreat atau retret, retret tapi bukan retret secara agama ya, tapi ini retret secara hubungan kalian dengan pasangan kalian, supaya kalian bisa lebih mengenal satu sama lain dengan baik. Nah, so, pas kalian retreat ini, pas honeymoon ini, jangan lupa sedikit perlihatkan sisi apa ya, sisi funnya kalian, sisi senang-senangnya kalian. Jangan lupa untuk sedikit bermain-main di sini. Bermain-main tapi artinya bukan sorry, bermain-main artinya bukan jahat ya. Bukan buat jahat, bukan nyurangin, bukan bikin apa nyurangin pasangan kalian, bukan. Tapi lebih kayak ya sedikit bermain-main lah di sini dalam hubungan kalian. Jangan terlalu dibawa serius gitu loh. Have fun aja, nikmatin aja, enjoy aja. Dan karena dengan kalian menambahkan sisi playfulnya kalian, itu akan menambah bumbu-bumbu percintaan dan akan menciptakan api asmara yang membara. Ya dong, kalau hubungan gak ada api asmaranya, dingin dong. Kan gak enak hubungan yang dingin, ya kan? Okay. Ini playfulness sebagai bottom of the deck ya. Sebagai bottom of the deck kalian ya, Virgo. This playfulness card is your bottom of the deck. Okay guys, Virgo, I guess that's it for now. So wrap, thank you for watching my video. Don't forget for news, for new viewers, don't forget to subscribe. And for existing viewers, but if you haven't subscribed my channel, don't forget to subscribe. And for you who already subscribed my channel, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Okay, I'll see you in the next reading next month. Okay, Virgo, sampai di sini dulu video saya. Terima kasih sudah menonton video saya ini. Jangan lupa, bagi kalian yang baru di channel saya, tolong di subscribe. Bagi yang sering nonton tapi belum subscribe, juga tolong di subscribe. Dan bagi kalian yang sudah subscribe, terima kasih, saya sangat menghargainya. Oke, sampai ketemu di video bulan depan, Virgo. And also, don't forget to like, share, and comment, plus subscribe. Jangan lupa untuk di like, di share, di comment, dan di subscribe. Oke, bye. Every single day.